Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Stijn Hoegaerts and I'm head of IT here at Van Marke. Together with Jan Ikrot, the managing partner of Mandify, we would like to share our experiences with Mandix and how we use it to strengthen our SAP S4 landscape whilst staying as close as possible to the SAP standard. But before I take you with me on our Mandix story, I would like to give the opportunity to Jan to introduce himself first.
So thank you, Stijn, for having me in this presentation, and thank you for our fruitful collaboration as well. Let me introduce myself. I'm Jan Ikrot from Mandify, and we are a Mandix partner. Our mission is to make organizations digitally future-proof. So we help our clients to get the best out of the Mandix platform. And we do this as a partner of both Mandix Siemens and SAP. So Stijn, please go ahead.
Thank you, Jan. Well, maybe just a few words about Van Marke first. We are a Belgian company headquartered here in Kortrijk, nearby the French border. And we are active in the sanitary, installation and HVAC business. After more than 90 years, we are still in the hands and led by the family Van Marke. We are market leader in Belgium and Luxembourg and growing in France, Switzerland, the Netherlands and also in the US. And though the Van Marke group entails different companies, our main occupation remains wholesale. Now, for a long time, it has been very clear and obvious what the role is of a wholesaler. But the last couple of years, we see that manufacturers are getting organized much better, and therefore they're directly selling to our installers and end customers. This is putting our business under pressure. From a management perspective, it means that we have to refocus on different business areas. Of course, the basis remains our core activity: buying, redistributing, and selling products. But it doesn't differentiate us from our competition. The only way how we can differentiate from our competitions is in the way or in the services that we offer to our customers. And they vary from online business 24/7, they can buy goods from us and have them delivered at their doorstep or at the wharf, in the services that we offer them in the form of calculators and configurators. And even we go that far that we can overtake and coordinate the home renovation with other actors like painters, electricians, and so on. Now, if you look at this picture, you can easily imagine that this is a high-level blueprint of our future system landscape. What I also see is two challenges. One of the challenges, and I think I share with many of you, is the fact that implementing an SAP program takes quite some time and money. And of course, we are being challenged to keep that budget as close as possible and as low as possible. But it means that you can do that if you can stay as much as possible to the standard. While at the same time, we have lots of business requirements which cannot be met by the standard and therefore require some enhancement to the system. That's one challenge. Second challenge that I have, and I share, and this is particularly for Van Marke, I do have an internal development team. But each of these developers have their own speciality, meaning that every time when we create a new configurator or calculator, that I have to assign this to one particular person. He or she takes his time that is necessary to build it, and because it's made with different technologies, often the user experience is not so fluent or unified across all the different services we offer. Now, in an ideal world, I will probably tell you that Mandix would solve all my challenges, but the reality is a bit more balanced. I do remember how I came across Mandix 2 years ago. I was on holiday and I got a phone call from a Mandix account manager asking me whether he disturbed me. I told him that I was on holiday and so it was an ideal moment. His answer was, excellent, then we have plenty of time to discuss what I'm going to tell you. And he started telling me about the Mandix platform and that you can build applications up to 6 times faster and that you don't even need IT for it. So I can imagine that quite some of my business colleagues would be very happy to hear this kind of a story, but I was not so amused and I politely turned him down. Now, I forgot even about Mandix, to be honest. A few months later, I was forced to recreate an application that we already had for many years on the smartphones of our customers. It was no longer compatible with the new Android version, which was upcoming, and therefore we had to rebuild it. Now, I could not assign it to one single developer because it would simply take too much time to rebuild. And therefore, we selected React Native, together with another partner. We rebuilt this application. And at the same time, I tried to introduce a new way of working as well, a more agile way of working based on Scrum methodology. In the beginning, it all went fine, But soon the downside, or the after the euphoria, the sobering came in. Initially, we estimated it to take only 3 months, but it actually took 6 months. And because we had announced to launch the new version in a national event, we could not postpone the launch, and therefore we had to reduce the scope in order to make sure that it was ready in time. This disappointment actually led to that we did not add any new features after the launch, even though it was well perceived by our customers. I shared this experience with one of our other partners, and he told me to look into Mendix the next time I would build an application. Around the same time, I think, I also got a phone call of the same account manager again, inviting me to come to Mendix World. And though I was a bit skeptical, I said, okay, let's give it a try and let's go and look. Once I was there at Mendix World, I talked to different application architects and various partners, amongst Jan here present as well. And they gave me a more balanced story. Yes, it is possible to build applications without IT, but the components used for these applications, they need to be built by an IT person. And secondly, the speed is not coming all by magic. It's by the fact that if you have multiple applications built by Mendix already in-house, it also means that you have multiple components that you can reuse, and therefore you can go faster the next time you build a new application. So, okay, this is more balanced, and I was convinced. Next thing I had to do is convince my manager, the CEO of this company. And so I started to make my business case. Now, in order to make sure that I would have enough applications so that we have a portfolio of components so that we can go always faster and faster, I made a list of different applications, both in the digital services area as well in the SAP area. What I did not anticipate was COVID. And what happened here is that we had to postpone our introduction of Mendix here at Van Marke because of the lockdown. Everybody was working from home, and we thought it was not ideal to train the people in Mendix. Now, at a certain moment, and I still remember, it was a Friday evening, my CEO challenged me in saying, can't we make a contact registering app? An app so that people could register all the people they met during the day, and so once they are contacted by the contract tracers, they can easily tell whom they met in the last couple of weeks. I was a bit puzzled because I knew that Apple and Google were already working on this, and they had some technical issues, certainly when they think of using Bluetooth. So on Saturday, I was working in my garden and rethinking all of this. And I thought maybe I can simplify without using Bluetooth, but then I still needed somebody who could build it. And that was actually the beginning of an SMS chat that I started with Jan. And by Sunday, actually, he accepted my challenge to work with me. And we had our plan and the design ready. And by the end of the week, our Stay Safe app was launched. More than 1,000 users at Van Marke were using it and were registering their contacts. So we had a great start of Mendix here at Van Marke, and it even got the noticed by the national newspapers, who wrote different articles about it. So we had high expectations created as well internally. Soon after this introduction, or this first application, we started working on some enhancements in SAP in combination with Mendix. The first one we built was a shop scanning app, which is used both by the staff as our customers. For our customers, it's used as a self-scan app. Yeah, you all know if you go to your local grocery. And in our case, our staff use it for standard transactions available in SAP in order to do the receivings or to tell the system that certain goods have moved from one shelf to another one, or to do cycle counting. All of them are done with this app. They take the data directly out of SAP. We do the processing, and then SAP is updated on the fly. Another one we built is the discount matrix app. In our case, customers, they get a discount when they buy goods from us. However, it's not the same discount percentage for every product they buy from us. It's all depending on the turnover in a certain product family they did last year, how they are perceived in growth, and this will lead to different discount percentages per product family. Now, I know you can do this in SAP, but as you also know, price conditions and maintaining them in SAP is not that easy. And if you add a layer of security that we would like to add to that, so that not every account manager can change the discount percentages of every customer, wherever in Belgium or in the rest of the group, it becomes a challenge to have this one in SAP. And therefore, we decided to build this app in Mendix. It fetches the data from SAP, it does the entire process of assigning the right discount percentages, and then afterwards it updates SAP immediately so that with the next order that customer places, he's entitled of the right discount percentages. Another one I would like to mention here is the quote generator. I know, again, in SAP you can easily create quotes. But if you know that we build about, or that we generate about 20,000 quotes every month, and that a quote is containing several tens to up to hundreds of lines, and that to ease our salespeople, they make use of template quotes from which they copy-paste lines into a new quote, then you know it's not so easy to do this in SAP. Again, it makes use of all the SAP data available in the system, it does the magic in the tool, and then updates SAP directly. Now, while doing these projects, we also noticed that we had to redirect a bit and to restructure our organization internally. And for that one, we introduced the concept of the App Factory. And this concept is something that Jan will explain a little bit more.
Thank you, Stan. Let me indeed explain about the App Factory that we've built together. First of all, for those who maybe are not familiar with the term of App Factory, what is an App Factory? An App Factory is a team, or let's say a set of teams, that build applications, multiple applications, together at scale according a standardized way of working. So what did we do to to implement this App Factory? First step was to assemble a team. And for Stan, it was a matter of refocusing existing resources, and that brought a new team with focus, with, let's say, increased capacity based on the Mendix platform. As a next step, we had the training. And in training, we typically combine theory, let's say the basic concept, with practice, let's say building a first application, and that really works fine. So the team grew rapidly in skills, and suddenly, as a next step, we could start co-creating applications at scale based on a standard way of working with templates, best practices, and guidelines. From the beginning, we also invited multiple business stakeholders so that co-creation with the business became possible with a focus on maximum added value. A last step, and very important one, is driving governance. So from the beginning, we created a governance way of working, where in practice, let's say by a bi-weekly meeting, we have a review of the planning and the results and how everything goes. And that's really important to keep track on the different teams that build applications. So that's in brief how we created the App Factory. So now I would like to hand it over back to Stan.
Okay, thank you, Jan. And indeed, it has been a quite of a journey until now. I think it was 18 months that we launched our first application here at Vermarke. And in all fairness, we still see room for improvement, as we say. But we also see already a lot of advantages in the combination of Mendix and SAP. The first one I can immediately see is that our development capacity got extended drastically. Before, I could only rely on SAP developers to create new features or to change functionality in SAP. And now I know that I have a development team at hand that can also build features which are linked into the SAP. Another thing which is highly appreciated by our users is the fact that they are more involved thanks to the bi-weekly sprint reviews, where they can see their requirements coming to life in the system. And the advantage of this this bi-weekly meeting is also that they can give feedback. They can feedback and see on where they see that we are a little bit deviating from what they originally requested for, or that their requirements were well perceived by us, but they meant it a little bit differently. And so they can tell us, okay, this is what I actually want. Another additional advantage of this close interaction between business and IT is when IT is open about the things they perceive as a big challenge, it's a big technical challenge to realize, that business can think along and they can start thinking of maybe simplifying or redefining, rephrasing their requirement so that it's not so big thing anymore to be built. One of the advantages that I honestly did not anticipate on in the beginning was the fact that because of the involvement of the non-SAP developers, they are now more and more motivated also. Because you know that an SAP project takes quite some time and money and budget and also managerial attention, and it often leads to some less attention to other initiatives. Now, these people working on a bigger SAP program makes them feel like they are part of the bigger thing. So that leads to an increase in motivation. A last thing, and I'm personally very happy about this one, remember my two challenges, is that by doing and adding the Mendix platform to our system landscape, I'm now capable of giving the business what they ask for and still staying as close as possible to the SAP standard. So I'm happy about it. Now, in all fairness, it hasn't been a walk in the park neither, and I had to overcome some of the challenges, which I could rephrase as some learnings that you might come across as well when you introduce Mendix at your company. First, I would say try to find support in your teams and as much as possible. And I honestly thought in the beginning that my developers would be the first one to embrace this challenge and that the business would be the last one to accept, but actually it was a reverse. It were my business people who are most enthusiastic about the introduction of this platform because of these closed loops and this strong involvement. And I was also expecting actually that my diehard SAP people, they would be reluctant to this change. But actually, once they saw the fact that that Mendix is respecting the document flows in SAP and that this Mendix platform could add features which are hard to realize in SAP, they embrace it as well. It were actually my web developers who were the most difficult ones to convince in using this platform. As Jan explained, we decided to go for co-creation, and I would definitely recommend it, because co-creation means that you're going to invite more experienced people that have already been working with Mendix in your team, and together you can realize successes much faster, and this helps with the motivations of everyone, and also you learn a lot from each other. Now, I know there are many partners outside there, and all have their strengths and weaknesses. But what I would recommend is choose one which is very close to the way of working that you are used to, so that it really becomes a partnership and not just a supplier. What I would also recommend you is do multiple projects in parallel, but keep your teams which are working on them small. This way, somebody working on a project can really go from A to Z. Since it's going fast in the creation of these applications, it doesn't make sense to really cut the work into more pieces. It's better to have somebody assigned to it and work from A to Z until it's fully delivered. And what Jan was already mentioning, in the very first, I think, three or four applications, we did not have a governance process. And we felt, okay, this is something we really need if we want to avoid that it becomes a messy thing with all new things that you start to introduce. A last thing, but very important as well, is don't underestimate the effort it takes and the time it takes to create web services or the so-called OData services. These are the web services that you need to link your Mendix applications with other systems, with SAP, but also other systems. And what you will see is often they take more time than creating the application itself. So start early with them, and also, very important, make sure you have a governance process around it as well. Try not to fall into the trap that you create web services for each application again and again. Otherwise, you will end up with a spaghetti of web services. It's better to think about it and say, okay, should I really create a new web service or reuse an existing one and maybe extend an existing service? And these are my recommendations for you. I know we went fast and there's lots of things to tell, even more than we have told you today. And therefore, we are, of course, open and willing to answer all your questions if you contact us. In the meantime, the only thing I can do, thank you very much for joining our session and wishing you good luck in your Mendix journey.
Thank you all and enjoy Mendix World. Bye.